Hello and welcome back to the Advanced Rocketry tutorial series. In the previous episode, we went through all of this. We can make steel, we can make silicon, we can make lots of basic stuff. So now it's time to move on with some machines. So that's only what we're going through today. Eventually, we will go up to space in the rocket over there, but we need a lot of things before we can do that. So in this tutorial video, we will only talk about machines that you will need before you go to space. So we'll actually begin with the crystallizer. Craft it with everything you've seen already from the last one, together with the quartz crucible. So if we go here in the hole projector and click the crystallizer, it looks like this. It's a 2x2x3 crystallizer, hatches, coils, and the coils will determine what speed you run it in. So if you use better coils, you will have higher speed. And then the second layer is quartz crucible, right? So there are two coils, and if you do it properly, you can have higher speed than I have. Here I've used copper and copper, it seems. And to run it, there's not too many recipes. So let's see, the crystallizer is here. The lithium dust that we couldn't process before, we couldn't make it into ingots, but we could crush it, is run in the crystallizer, as well as the silicon ingot together with one nugget. This will give 10 nuggets, I guess. And that gives the silicon boule, perhaps. So the lithium and silicon, let's hit the switch. And this is how it runs. And you get the output in the output hatch, and everything is done. So after that, perhaps you would like to build a lathe. The once again, holo projector. The only thing new here is, except for these ones, is that we have a motor. So let's take a look at that. The lathe looks like the other recipes, very similar. But the motor comes, like with the coils, you can get different speeds out. So there are four different ones: motor, advanced, enhanced, and elite. And the machine speed is the only difference. So with steel and gold, or aluminium and titanium, or iridium with titanium, the machine will run faster. That's the only difference. So the interface looks very similar. You recognize it. You have the 4x speed, so I use an elite motor here. Here I have some ingots waiting for me, and the purpose of this is to make rods. In this machine, one rod will give, or one ingot will give you two rods. But the normal recipe that we had in the previous one had 3 to 4. So compare 3 to 4 to 1 to 2. So lathe, perhaps not required, but worth it totally. Next machine is the precision assembler. So this is a bit larger. It only contains, well, various parts. But other than the assembler block itself, I think it's only things that you've seen already. Precision. You see machine structures, hatches, and you can actually move them around a little bit. We have double motors, structures, glass, and more structures. And this one is kind of neat because you use it to make various types of lots of different items. So for example, here I can make bionic leg upgrades. We can combine wafers to get basic circuits plates. and the wafers are done in the cutting machine. We'll come to that later. Precision, here it is. So from now on, I will only refer to items like they are made in the precision assembler. So I will put some stuff in it, perhaps this one. Control circuit board and a motor will give you bionic leg upgrades. So motor and a circuit board. And then we flip the switch, I hope. Ah, I was missing an advanced circuit for some reason made in the cutting machine. So with that. All right, so now it works. It turned out I had some stuff in the output hatch, so that's why it didn't run. But now it's using all the components that I put in to make, in this case, the bionic leg upgrade. Ends up in the output hatch, and well, with that we can actually make something more as well. So if you take a look in the assembler, and we'll make perhaps a basic circuit, redstone and emerald. It will immediately run, and this will craft us the, what was this, the hover upgrade, I think. Well, let's see. It was a data storage unit. So a lot of items are made this way, and from now on, as I said, I will just refer to them as they are made in the assembler. So then you know how to do it, all right? So now we can move on to the next machine. Now let's see, it's over here. It's the cutting machine. So if you take a look here, I've cleaned everything up. Good. Oak, circuits, plates, and well, things like that. They will run and they will be cut. Both wood and circuits are made in this one. So we take a look here in the cutting machine. Normal wood, but also silicon to make wafers and circuits plates. They are made in the assembler with the silicon wafer and so on. So, and you craft it simply by making a saw blade, an assembly with more iron. You need a motor for it. You have it in cutting machine here. Input, cutting, output, power, and the assembly from here, oops, and the motor. And it's only one layer. And with that, well, then you get the steel gears and make a cutting machine. Very similar recipes to the other ones. Also a machine that you really can't be without in this when you're doing advanced rocketry. So when you have all of those machines, we are getting quite close to be able to craft the things we need for the rocket. But we also need fuel, so I'll go through that as a final thing. The first machine you need is the electrolyzer. And here I'm using an aqueous accumulator to pump in water in the back in the fluid input hatch. So steel and various things, basic circuits, you know how to make them by now. So let's see if I can find the electrolyzer here. Fluid output, machine structures, fluid input, a coil which will determine the speed, and then some power plugs. So what this does is that it will insert from the water and you apply power to it. The interface is also just on and off. And I think we are now full, so it won't run. So perhaps I can get some tanks and we can empty things out. Well, great, now it runs. So this indicates that it's running. So it's separating the water into oxygen and hydrogen with only power and water. And there is a need both Well, first you need oxygen and hydrogen in the next machine to make rocket fuel. But you can also use the oxygen for your spacesuit because you need air to breathe or oxygen to breathe in this case in the up in space. And you need hydrogen for your jetpack. And we'll cover that in the next video in this series. But in either way, you charge them in the gas charge pads, or gas. You can either put a pressure tank in it or simply step on it when you have the suit on you. But we'll get to that in the next video. Charge pads with some fans and fuel tanks. It's pretty simple. Just connect it to a pipe and pump the oxygen or hydrogen in them. In this case, I'm using the fluid duct. I had some issues using the well, it's called liquid pipes, but sometimes it works and sometimes it didn't, so that's why I switched. But for you, it probably works just fine. And you need to suck it out. You can't, it will not auto output. So here I'm using a servo just to auto extract from the hatch. I think you just use a redstone lever with the liquid pipe. So pump both these gases into the next machine, the chemical reactor. Gold circuits, stuff like that. And let's see, chemical reactor, we have it here. Nothing strange, nothing you haven't already seen. Motor, power, hatches, and the reactor and some more hatches. So what we'll do here is the interface is very similar. On this side, I'm inputting fluid, well, it's not a fluid, it's a gas in this case, oxygen in here and hydrogen in here. Together, they will, then you have an input hatch here. I guess you can put tanks in them to automate that. And here is the fluid output from this, and here comes the rocket fuel. Simply turn it on, and it will produce rocket fuel very slowly, 20 millibuckets there, and so on. 20 more, and you will need quite a lot before you can go to space. So this will need to run for quite some time. But I'll turn it off because it's noisy. So with that done, you have almost everything you need to go to space. But there's probably a good idea to have tanks. You will need them to carry with you. You will need it for your spacesuit. So as a final thing, the rolling machine. Again, very similar recipe, fluid control item. And we'll take a look here in the rolling machine. Fluid input, coils here in the back, structures. Well, as I said, nothing you haven't already seen. But with this one needs water. Let's take a look here. There is no fluid input. Yeah, here's the water. You don't need to pump it in, but I'm doing that. You can put tanks in here instead. And in here, let's see if we can find the hatches. Output hatch, and over here is the input. Ah, come on. Input. So in here, we can put plates, for example, and that in the output will give us. All right, so let's do like this instead. Rolling machine, and like to take a look at this. So with the ingots, you can make plates, and you should have water with them. I think this is all right. And with plates, you can make sheets. And let's see the final One is with sheets you will make the tanks. So low, well, normal pressure, high pressure, super high pressure, and the difference is that they will contain different amounts. I think the low pressure is 1. Let's see, this high pressure is 4 buckets. Then I think the pressure is 2 and the lower is 1, and then this is 8 buckets. And then you can put the tanks in the charge pads, or I think you can put them here as well. And then you use them to your rocket or, well, with your spacesuit. So now we have everything we need to, well, to get to space, but first we need to be in space. So next episode, spacesuit, and then after that, we'll go to moon. Right, I hope I have covered everything. In other ways, just ask a question and I'll do my best to answer. So thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.